Chris Chinnock here, Insight Media, CES 2025. This is the Continental booth. They're showing three display solutions we want to take you through. The first one over here is they call their invisible biometrics display. There's actually three sensors that they've integrated behind this OLED panel. So the first one is an invisible display. So behind this OLED display is a single CMOS sensor, visible sensor, and they modified the OLED panel here to allow the some more transmissivity to allow the capture of the image. It's invisible, so the driver's not aware of it, but the whole idea here is you're doing driver monitoring for safety purposes. The driver's distracted or drowsy. The second sensor they have is basically a spectrometer on a chip. So the driver or passenger puts their finger up onto the sensor, which is located somewhere in the cockpit, and it can look at the molecules of alcohol in the skin without doing any kind of a pinprick or any other invasive application. So this is a concept here. But you can potentially think about putting this into the start button on a car to make it not allow a drunk driver to get behind the wheel. You can also potentially do hydration measurements. Blood sugar was the other potential application, near-term application you could do with the spectrometer. Let's take a look at the third application. The third sensor is this dot generator. This is a small device, again, hidden behind the display. Hidden behind the display. And the idea is you create this, obviously, this dot pattern here. It's a very simple device. And by doing some analysis of this, is a form of structured light. They're using this in particular for seatbelt identification. So it's you want to be able to determine that the driver is properly buckled in before they can take off. There's one other use of this. They can also do a depth detection, create a depth map using this dot pattern, which can be used to determine how far the driver is away or if they're maybe even not even present at all. Let's move on to the next demo. The next demo I want to show is their window projection demo. Here you can see this is the idea is to use this to create images or text messages on the outside of the car window. So the way this thing works, this is a projector that's up inside the roof of the car. The demo would be in this case, and on the window there's actually a laminated PDLC LCD between the two pieces of glass here. So the PDLC can be activated, turned on and off. When it's off, the window is transparent, so the passenger can see out, even if there's an image on there. It's you can actually see the image, but it's very poor image from the inside. Actually, I'll go around and take a look at that if I can. And I can see a little bit here. Yeah, it's very faint and visible. But if the PDLC screen is turned on, then it becomes basically a black screen. They've actually can embed black pigments in the PDLC polymer to create this basically a black screen, so it becomes much more visible to the outside. Number of applications they're talking about here could be like a Uber or Lyft, driver or passenger identification. It could be used for restaurants. It could be used for advertising of all kinds. I had a little video failure, so I wanted to add some additional information from Continental, specifically on the window projection display. They were showing a mock-up of the DLP projector that would typically be used in this application, and it's a pico projector, maybe 2 inches by 2 inches by an inch or so. But the company's also invested in a company called Trilight, an Austrian company, and they are developing a three laser RGB laser to waveguide solution. This waveguide combines, it's a special waveguide that combines the three laser beams into a single one, and then puts that onto a MEMS scanner. And they're putting this together as an integrated package, and it is tiny. It's like the size of your fingernail. So the commercialization timeframe for this remains a little unclear, but clearly having such a tiny projector instead of something a little bit larger is very appealing to all the auto manufacturers and tier one suppliers. Now, there is some concern perhaps with using laser scanning. It has had very mixed results in terms of creating images. But for symbology, it may be a little bit better, but we'll just have to see. A second demo that I didn't get a chance to provide more audio on is there's a Swarovski crystal one. And here, the idea of using the Swarovski crystal display is to create emotion in the cockpit. You're not trying to measure the emotion of the drivers or passengers. You're trying to evoke emotion in the cockpit and in the passengers and driver. So having these very beautiful finishes on the crystal is the idea. So they showed two displays. One was, I believe it's a 3.5-inch micro LED device from ViewReel, which they showed last year. And this year they added about a 10-inch or so LCD panel, more of a center console kind of a demo, again with this nice gold finish. In business news, the company has been talking about spinning out its automotive division, and pending board of directors approval, that is now planned to happen in the fall of 2025. And I believe it will also be listed on one of the European stock exchanges as well. So that is the sum of the business and technology information I wanted to add. Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.